Michael Zobchak versus Bernard Carter, 45 CO 1308, MI 122.
Michael Sherry, here's the state of Indiana.
There's some scratchy. Anybody here yet? Oh, let's pass it. They'll be here in a little bit. Next case is Adam Shropshire versus state of Indiana. Was continued till October 1st, 2 p.m.
No objection.
Okay. Vuk Jovanovic versus prosecuting attorney of Lake County. 45 CO 1 1307 MI 1303.
I'm 103.
Okay, this one is also, I guess we'll continue this one.
No objection, Your Honor.
Until October 1st. Looks like there's a motion for a continuance. Yeah. Kenneth Williams versus Scott Waddell, Commissioner of Bureau of Motor Vehicles, 45 CO 1 1307 MI 106. We have Angela Jones on behalf of the petitioner. Raise your right hand if you sworn, sir. You solemnly swear affirm tell the whole truth, nothing but the truth to the best of your knowledge. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Hi. Please state your name.
Kenneth Williams.
Mr. Williams, where do you reside?
4049 Kentucky, here in Indiana.
How long have you lived there?
About 10, 11 years.
And Mr. Williams, you're here seeking a probationary license, is that correct?
Yes.
And your license is suspended for failure to provide proof of insurance?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
You currently now have you obtained insurance?
Yes, I have.
Okay. And is your suspension due to be up on about the end of September?
Then in October.
October?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And where do you work, sir?
I work for an advertising agency downtown Chicago, Young and Rubicam.
Okay. And you need a vehicle to go back and forth to work?
Yes, ma'am.
And are you full-time there?
Yes, ma'am.
And your hours, are they full-time? I'm sorry. Do you work set hours? Do you work evening hours sometimes?
Sometimes. We have to work late.
So there's no set schedule maybe on weekends or on weekdays?
Well, weekends I'm off.
Now, you need, has it been a financial hardship for you not to be able to drive back and forth to work?
Sometime.
How have you been getting around? Have you been getting a ride from people?
To the back and forth, maybe to the train station. I take the train in.
Okay.
Mm.
But it's quicker and cheaper for you to go and use your vehicle?
Well, I prefer to commute from the train station. You know, I just use my vehicle because sometimes we have different projects. And I have to drive downtown, and I can't determine when those projects are going to pop up.
Okay. All right. Are you asking this court to grant your probationary license so that you can use it to go back and forth to work?
Yes, ma'am.
As well as for the necessities of life, such as going to the grocery store, medical appointments?
And to church.
And to church.
Yeah.
Okay. I have nothing to tell
you. Cross-examination. Have you filed proof of insurance with the Bureau of Motor Vehicles?
Yes, I have, sir.
Was there an accident involved in your loss of your license?
Yes, it was.
Have you made restitution for that accident?
Actually, that accident is still in court.
I'm sorry?
I'm still in court. But I'm not in court, but my attorney is handling that for me. I was at a stop sign and somebody hit me, and that's what caused all the,
Nothing further, Your Honor.
Okay, was, why was insurance not?
Did you unintentionally fail to pay for insurance?
No, I was actually, I was purchasing that month-to-month insurance, and I had let that month lapse. The accident happened actually around the time it was due. And it was a couple of days, actually, it was actually during the 9th, and I had, I mean, on the 15th, and I had my accident on the 9th.
And did you immediately procure insurance once you discovered that?
Yes, I did. I went right and got it straightened out, and it's been that way ever since.
And since that time, you had no lapses in insurance?
No, ma'am.
So it was inadvertent? Is that what you testified to?
It was inadvertent. You didn't mean, intentionally mean not to have insurance?
No, I didn't. No.
Anything else?
No, no.
Anything else?
Nothing else, Your Honor.
You may step down, sir. Thank you. All right, court will grant the petition. If you have an order, then you'll submit it.
We can submit it.
Wait. I'm going to remove the one hand here. Thank you for the call. There's an order in here.
Oh, there's okay. Thanks.
What is the date
Scott Waddell, 45 CO11307 MI105.
So you want to raise your right hand? You solemnly swear affirm tell the officers nothing but the truth to the best of your knowledge?
Yes.
Please be seated. Ms. Jones, you may proceed.
Please state your name, sir.
Fred Gabriel.
And Mr. Gabriel, what's your date of birth?
5/12/80.
And you're approximately 32 years of age?
Yes.
Okay. And Mr. Gabriel, you've never been given a probationary license by this court, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. And your license has been suspended since on about July the 4th of this year due to failure to have insurance, is that correct?
Yes.
And it was inadvertent or unintentional that you did not have insurance, is that correct?
Yes.
In fact, you provided me with proof of insurance showing that you now have insurance on the vehicle, is that correct?
Yes.
And you currently are enrolled in school and you're also under therapy, is that correct?
Yes.
You need a vehicle to go back and forth for your medical appointments and to go to college, is that correct?
Yes.
Are you asking this court to grant your probationary license so that you can in fact perform those duties?
Yes.
You also have dependents, children?
Yes.
How old are they?
I got a 1-year-old, a 5-year-old, a 7-year-old, and 18, and a 16-year-old, or 15.
They're allowing you for support?
Yes.
And you need those money, the car also, so that you can attend to your children and any needs that they may have?
Yes.
And you're asking this court to grant a probationary license up until and including October the 2nd, 2013?
Yes.
I have nothing further.
Was there an accident involved in your suspension?
It was like a month that accident.
Did you have insurance at the DMV after your accident?
No, I didn't. Actually, my insurance, my car insurance was over a month. My insurance was due on the 12th, the day of the accident.
Okay.
And that was on the Sunday, and I was going to wait that money to pay for it.
Have you made restitution to the other person in the accident?
No, I ain't heard.
So you haven't made any payments, sir?
I was paying for my insurance.
No, so the other party in the accident, have you?
No, I haven't. They haven't been in contact with me, the other party in the accident.
Nothing further, yeah.
Was it inadvertent, or what happened?
You were driving your mother's vehicle?
Yes.
Okay, and she is in fact in court today?
Yes.
And she had forgot to make a payment on that insurance? And that insurance is now current, is that correct?
Yes.
And there's been no lawsuits or contact at all regarding that accident, is that correct?
Yes.
I have nothing further, Your Honor. And I do have verification that mom does have insurance.
Anything else from the state? Have you made any attempts to find out anything about the other person in the accident, such as giving an accident report?
Yeah, I got an accident report and everything, but...
Have you tried to contact the other party?
No, I didn't try to contact.
How'd the accident happen?
She ran a stop sign. I had the right of way. And she came out on that, and nobody just hit me for no reason.
Court grants petition.
Thank you, Your Honor. I do have a letter prepared for
her. There was some in the file, I said.
I had to make a typographical change. I put 20.
All right. You may step down. Okay. All right. Give me your orders. I'll throw these away.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Jacob Roberts versus Bernard Carter, 45 CO 1 1207 MI 108.
Afternoon, Your Honor.
Afternoon.
Amanda hired on behalf of the petitioner Jacob Roberts. Your Honor, Madhu Mena on behalf of the Bureau of Motor Vehicles.
Okay. We have an agreed order imposing stay on license suspension and all proceedings pending final appellate decision. Okay. Has there been a decision?
There has, Your Honor. We were waiting to see if the Supreme Court was going to grant transfer, and they actually denied transfer sometime, I think, in April. At this point, Your Honor, I've spoken with the Attorney General's office. I believe we just need a briefing schedule to submit to the court.
What was the appellate court's decision?
Your Honor, that... essentially, that the doctrine of laches can apply to a governmental agency on a showing of extreme unfairness. That was one of the allegations in the verified petition for judicial review. And we believe that if the court were to hear evidence on that and the Supreme Court were to overturn it, it would, you know, be a waste of judicial economy to hear that argument. Now that we know it can apply in some circumstances, we're prepared to move forward.
What was the court's original rule? What did I rule on this?
No, Your Honor. This is a case out of Monroe Circuit Court.
It was a case out of Monroe Circuit Court, which was dispositive of some of the issues here?
Correct.
Yes, sir. For the record, there were two cases that went to the Court of Appeals on the same set of issues. One was the Orndorff case that the counsel is referring to, in which the doctrine of latches was applied. The other case was called Thomas v. BMV. That case also went to the Court of Appeals and came out the other way, in which the court declined to apply the doctrine of latches to the petitioner with a very similar set of facts, state police as the petitioner in this case. So we feel that it's a factual question, and therefore a briefing schedule.
So in one case they applied it, in the other case they didn't?
That's correct.
What else?
And transfer was denied in both cases.
All right. Okay, so you need a briefing schedule?
That is correct.
Okay, how much time do you need?
30 days.
30 days? To submit the briefs and set it for hearing? 30 day, October 1st? No. Yeah, well, let me see. 30 days. Okay, September 16th. Submit a brief and response. October 16th. You want time to reply?
If needed, I don't believe.
If you need a reply, October 31st. And then we'll set it for Tuesday, November 12th, 2 o'clock.
Your Honor, one final issue. The agreed order saying the license suspension is set to expire. We would ask that the agreed order stay in effect until this court makes a final decision.
Your Honor, the state would oppose that simply because the petitioner has three lifetime suspensions that are current, and whether or not the suspension comes back into effect or not seems irrelevant considering those other three lifetime suspensions.
You mean the suspension has been stayed up till now?
That's correct.
Corporation motion. Prepare an order to that effect.
Thank you.
Anything else?
No, Your Honor, just to confirm the dates, it was petitioner's brief due by September 16th, a response due by October 16th, a reply by October 31st, and a status hearing on November 12th.
That's it.
Thank you.
For arguments on the briefs.
Thank you.
Make sure Nikki gets that date for the kids. Here. All right. Antonio Wiley versus Scott Waddell, 45 CO1 1306 MI98. Sir, you want to raise your right hand to be sworn? You solemnly swear, affirm, tell the whole truth. Tell you about the truth to the best of your knowledge. Please be seated.
Name, please?
Antonio Wiley.
And you date of birth?
10/2/66.
And where do you live, sir?
7587 Beach Avenue, Hammond, Indiana.
How long have you lived there, sir?
About a year and a half.
How long have you lived in Lake County, Indiana?
About 10 years.
And sir, are you currently employed with My Transportation?
Yes.
And the corporate office is located in Phoenix, Arizona?
Yes.
Okay, but local.
I'm an independent contractor.
You're an independent contractor. Thank you. All right. Sir, you drive as a part of your job occupation, is that correct?
Correct.
In fact, as far as the insurance on this particular vehicle, you failed to have insurance on a particular day.
Well, it lapsed at midnight that night,
yes.
And I was just getting in from Minnesota, and as I was coming home, the lady ran the stop sign and pulled my car out.
Okay. And you did run, did you run out of insurance?
Matter of fact, I paid insurance that night.
But it didn't go through until after midnight?
No, it went through, that day, but at the time of the suspension, they said at the time of the accident, it wasn't covered, so.
Okay, so there was a few hours difference between the date of the lapse and the date of when you were in, when you got in that morning?
Correct.
Okay, so was it unintentional that you felt that your insurance was, unintentional? You didn't mean not to pay your insurance?
No, I didn't mean not to pay, I mean, it was.
Okay, you now have insurance, is that correct?
Correct.
Okay, this suspension is due to end on or about September 29th of 2013?
Yes.
And you asked for probationary license to go through that day?
Yes.
Okay, and you've never had an insurance for this type, never had a violation of this kind ever?
No.
Okay, and you also work during the weekdays as well as weekends?
Correct.
Okay, I have nothing further, Your Honor.
Cross exam.
Have you made any comments with regard to the accident?
But the accident was their fault.
Has that been decided in court?
I can't get no information. I got the police report. Everything on the police report is false. Everything you run the lead is false.
Did you get an accident report?
Yes.
Did you try and contact the other party?
Yes.
And what happened with them?
Nothing. They don't leave at the address. There's no telephone number. There's no insurance. There's nothing. My truck is sitting in my yard totaled.
Anything else?
Nothing
further. You may step down.
Thanks, sir.
All right. Anything further?
Nothing.
All right. We have a petition. Do you have an order?
Yes, I do.
Okay, Kenneth Wissington versus Scott Waddell, 45 CO 1306 MI 97. Raise your right hand, be sworn, sir. Do you solemnly swear firm, tell all the truth and nothing but the truth to the best of your knowledge? Please be seated.
Kenneth Wissington.
And Mr. Wissington, where do you reside?
4919 Fence Drive, Sherbourne, Indiana.
How long have you lived there?
My entire life.
Okay. And how old are you now?
18.
Okay. And Mr. Wissington, you recently graduated from high school.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yes.
Four times, correct?
So far.
Now, Mr. Wissington, you're currently employed at a variety of jobs.
Yes.
Okay, you do some part-time modeling?
Yes.
You work at Abercrombie Finch?
Yes.
And you also work at New Shiloh Methodist Baptist Church in Gears?
Sometimes my dad makes me.
Okay. At some point you were pulled over and you did not have insurance, is that correct?
No. I was hit in an accident.
Okay.
And at the time I was not ready, I didn't have insurance.
Okay. The insurance was in your father's name?
Yes.
Okay, your father has said he's here today.
Yeah, my dad's right there.
And he has since procured insurance?
Yes.
Okay. And you were residing with your dad at the time of this accident?
Yes.
All right. Your driving privileges are due to be reinstated on or about September 15th of 2013?
Yes.
Are you asking the court to grant you a probationary license until that suspension is up?
Yes, I am.
And you need that to go back and forth to, you go to school?
I'll go to Purdue Cal starting Friday, actually, and I go to Chicago like 2 or 3 times a week.
Okay, so you need to go back and forth to school as well as to work, is that
yes.
correct? And your dad now has insurance, is that also correct?
That's correct, yes.
Okay, and it was unintentional on your part, you did not know your dad had
insurance? I did not know at all.
I have nothing for you, Your Honor.
Cross examination?
Do you need any restitution in the accidents?
Yes, as we have, they're paying for damages.
Sorry?
They're paying for damages, yes.
Okay, so the other party was at fault?
Yes, she raked it back in me. Yeah.
Nothing further.
Thank you. You missed it.
Thank you.
Court grant petition. In order.
I have one in the file. Oh, you do? Okay, then we can use that.
Is anybody here yet on Michael Sobchak?
Oh, okay. Yes.
This is Bernard Carter, 45 CO1, 1308 MI 122. Yes. You're going to raise your right hand and be sworn. You saw and swear firm, tell the whole truth and nothing but truth to best your knowledge.
I do.
Please be seated.
Sir, could you state your name?
Michael Sobchak.
And you live in Hoboken, Indiana, is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay, and you've received notice from the Indiana Bureau of Motor Vehicles that your driving privileges have been suspended as a result of not having insurance?
Yes,
that
I have.
You received that notice in July of
2013? Yes, I have.
And you currently work at Modern Drop Forge?
Yes, I do.
And what do you do there?
I'm a millwright.
Okay, and as a millwright, do you have to travel for work?
Yes, we have two locations, one in Indiana and one in Illinois.
Okay, and do you have to travel to both locations?
Yes, I do.
Okay, how many dependents do you have?
I have 2 daughters, a son, and a child on the way.
Okay, and do you support them financially?
Yes, I do.
Okay, and would they suffer a hardship if you were not able to work to provide support?
Yes, they would.
Okay, and your failure to have insurance, was that inadvertent?
Yes, it was. I have a 6-month policy, and I got the month messed up. I thought I had it for another month, and I forgot to pay the bill.
Prior to your ticket for the new insurance, did you have insurance? Did you maintain insurance prior
to
that?
Yes, I have. Yes, sir.
Okay. And since that time, have you maintained insurance?
Yes, I have.
In fact, you currently have an insurance policy that's valid through January 2014?
Yes, I do.
I have no further questions,
sir. Question.
Was there an accident involved in this?
Yes, there was, sir.
Have you paid restitution in this accident?
It was very minor, and to my knowledge, it was just my car. There was no damage there.
Have you made any attempts to contact the other party to find out if they've had damages?
I have not. I obtained the police report, and it only showed damage to my car.
Have you had a prior operating while intoxicated?
Yes, I have, 10 years ago.
Nothing further than the statement. Anything else?
Oh, nothing further.
You may step down, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Court grants petition. Do you have an order?
Thank you, Mayor.
Is that all we had?
That's it.
Okay.
All right, court's adjourned. All rise.